Greetings. I watched a video recently and was very impressed by the visualizations covering the material. It is called the Most Logical Rapture Theory Power Packed Version by Eternal Rhythm Flow. I completely resonate with the truths this brother presents and have presented some of them in my own brute force way. The Tetrad of 2014-2015, the Seven Feasts of the Lord. But maybe it is his style of presentation, or his use of stellarium. This brother presented something clear and new to me. Revelation 12:1, and there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. Maybe you've seen this and know this already. And maybe I'm a skeptic and slow on the uptake, but I think what this brother's video covers makes sense. Revelation 12:1, and there appeared a great wonder in heaven. Okay, I've always imagined this as symbolism, imagery, metaphor, you know, woo-woo prophecy kind of stuff. Along the lines of, maybe if you are in the right place, then you can catch the imagery or symbolism. Luke 21:25, and there shall be signs in the sun, and in the moon, and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations, with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. Signs in the sun and moon. Eclipses, right? Though I think the sun exploding would be a pretty neat firework show for the half of the world that was awake. The Tetrad of 2014-2015 looked very convincing for signs in the sun and moon. But what about signs in the stars? We always link comets as harbingers. And maybe, sometimes they are. And meteors make an impressive show, especially with the proliferation of dash cams around the world. But what about signs in the actual stars? What about a planetary and solar alignment of note? Revelation 12:1, and there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. Let's look at the points of this prophecy. Imagine Islam claimed this was Muhammad's mother. They have not. I said imagine. And there appeared, one, a great wonder in heaven, two, a woman, three, clothed with the sun, and four, the moon under her feet, and five, upon her head, a six, crown of 12 stars. 1. Does the wonder in heaven mean the heaven of God's throne? I don't think so, for two reasons. This is called a sign, but heaven is invisible. And the next verse ascribes childbirth, so this woman is pregnant, perhaps symbolically. A third possible meaning is a sign in the stars, like the star that led the Magi. Point 2. A woman. Not a man, or a tree, or a fish, dog, or cat. You can rule out virtually anything that does not involve a woman. Clothed with the sun. Just gotta be imagery, right? I mean, the sun is a trillion times the size of Earth. This could not be literal in any possible interpretation. The sun is just too big and too hot to wear. The moon under her feet. She's real tall, whoever she is. But this points to a sign in the astronomical heavens. Mention of the sun and moon just kinda does that. Upon her head relates the position or orientation of what follows. We already know she wears the sun and stands on the moon. Crown of 12 stars. And now we are told she has 12 stars in her crown, or near her head. I admit, that passage has always seemed real hard to imagine, until I saw the picture. On September 23rd, 2017, a unique star, planet, moon, and sun alignment will take place. This is an image from a program called Stellarium. It's free, you can download it. You can set the date and time to the one I've shown you. Now let's examine the points of this prophetic vision, of this imagery. And there appeared a great wonder in heaven. A constellation would fit that description of being in the heavens. A woman. This is the constellation Virgo. Virgo is a woman, not a lion or something else. But aren't constellations assigned by men? Yes, they are, but that does not prevent God from referencing the imagery he knew we would assign. Clothed with the sun. You can see the sun appears in the constellation at this date. This also means the sign will be during daylight when it is too bright for men to see. Her radiance will be dazzling, which is another meaning of clothed by the sun. Point 4, the moon under her feet. The moon is the fastest object involved in this alignment. Every day the moon travels over 15 degrees of view. Move one day earlier or later, and the moon is not under her feet. Upon her head a crown of 12 stars. The constellation at her head is Leo, the lion. Leo has 9 stars in the constellation. But during this time, 3 planets help out, making 12 points of light or stars in her crown. If you've watched my other videos, you know I'm not a flake. I take a logical and thorough approach to seeking the truth in the Word of God. And at first glance, this seems like a coincidence. But the more I honestly examined the prophecy of Revelation 12:1, the more this left me speechless. Ignore this at your peril. The skeptic would muse, has this pattern ever taken place before? That's a great question. And it's the kind of question I ask all the time to debunk and refute nonsense. And I don't know for sure because I have not run Stellarium backwards for 2,000 years. You can if you want, and let me know if you do. The other important note is Revelation 12 describes mid-tribulation events. Be a good Berean. Dig into this and verify it for yourself. If the middle of the tribulation is September 2017, then 3.5 years earlier, it will just be beginning. You do the math. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.